Hare Krishna. The essence of education is enlightenment, engagement, and encouragement. When we want to share something with others, when we want to direct others to make a particular choice, we may often think that I just tell them, do this, don't do this. That is enough. But instruction alone is not enough. When we need to give enlightenment. Enlightenment means that we tell them what is the consequence of doing this and what is the consequence of doing that. Then when they themselves can see the results of those choices, then they will be able to choose wisely. Krishna does this in the Bhagavad-Gita. Krishna doesn't just give commandments to Arjuna. Krishna gives choices and consequences. For example, in 18.58, he says that if you become conscious of me, you'll pass over all obstacles by my grace. If you don't, you'll be lost. Machitta sarva durgani mat prasadat tarishyasi atha chetum ahankara nashoshyasi vinangshyasi. So this is enlightenment, to provide people understanding of how choices lead to consequences. Then along with that, we also need to give engagement. Engagement means that if you tell people, take this path, but if that path is very difficult for them, then we need to provide them facilities by which they can take that path. If parents want their children to practice spirit, to also do something spiritual, they can't expect the children to come and hear classes for adults. There need to be a kid's school. There need to be a facility for them to follow that path according to their level. And that's where the Bhagavad Gita is expert. Krishna provides, for example, in 12.8 to 12.12, multiple levels at which people can connect with him. So if you can always think of me, that's best. If you can't, then strive to think of me by practicing bhakti. If you can't do that, then just work for me. If you can't work for me, then you act selflessly and sacrifice the fruits of your work for a good cause. So this way, Krishna offers engagement at various levels so that people can connect at the level that they are at. And then, even this is not enough, because people may be able to go, but will they want to go? Spiritual life especially is seen as optional by people. And unless they feel inspired and encouraged to go that way, they may not. And this, therefore, we also need to encourage people. Encourage means we give them the confidence that you can do it and you have it in within you. Ultimately, Krishna is with you, and being with Krishna, you can practice. You can progress. Krishna gives this encouragement, especially in the end of the Bhagavad Gita, when he tells Arjuna how you are so dear to me. In 18.65, he states that, 18.64 itself, he says that you are extremely dear to me, that there is no one more dear to me than you. That's what he says when he says in that section of verses. And he assures Arjuna that if there is any trouble, I will protect you from all sinful reactions. Aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshayishyami ma shuchaha. So in this way, when Krishna gives confidence to Arjuna, then that Arjuna feels encouraged. And the result of that is, Arjuna at the end of the Bhagavad Gita in 18.73 says, yes, I will do your will. Karishye vachanam tava. So when we want to educate people to take certain choices, we need to have all these three together. Enlightenment, engagement, and encouragement. Thank you. Hare Krishna.